Why do we get shorter as we age? First of all, I want to make it clear I'm talking about your height or how tall. I'm Dr. John Shim, and I hope you've already had an opportunity to review my videos about basic spine anatomy and why discs degenerate. Understanding those concepts are very helpful to understanding the explanation to the common question of why do we get shorter as we age? Besides the spine, there are other reasons why we get shorter, but we will concentrate strictly on the spine. In the disc degeneration video, the concept of disc dehydration and the resultant narrowing of the disc base was presented. As the animation will demonstrate, the once tall, normal-sized disc of our youth will give way to a dehydrated, bulging, and narrowing disc. The disc height can significantly reduce. The vertebral body sandwich, or the so-called functional spine unit, is composed of the vertebral bodies alternating with the intervertebral disc. There are some population differences, but most collected anatomy data indicates a normal disc height for men averages about 11 millimeters and for women 9 millimeters. Population studies have definitely demonstrated a narrowing and degeneration of the discs with age. Interestingly, not every disc in every person will narrow, but in general, the narrowing disc will occur in almost every person. The current conventional wisdom is that after age 40, we shrink an average of 1/4 to 1/3 of an inch every decade. In addition to the disc decrease, there's another effect secondary to the change of the shape of the disc in the functional spine unit. When young, the spine has a natural, three-smooth, visible curve orientation. The neck or cervical spine gently curves backwards. The upper back or thoracic spine curves forwards. The lower back or lumbar spine curves backwards. The backward curves are called lordosis. The forward curve is called kyphosis. In the normal situation, the head is balanced over the pelvis, and this allows the most efficient use of body energy to maintain proper mechanics and orientation. As the discs degenerate and narrow, it causes the lordotic curvatures to straighten and the kyphosis to become more curved. As a result, to keep the head positioned for the pelvis, oftentimes the knees and the hips need to be slightly bent to maintain the proper position and balance. This change of posture results in the shortening or shrinking of the height. Osteoporosis can also be a significant contributing factor to shortening. The bones collapse, causing loss of height and also causing more kyphosis. As discussed before, the body must compensate for this kyphosis by again bending at the hips and knees. As you now understand, the disc degeneration process leads to shrinkage or shortening by both a reduction in disc height and a change in the posture to achieve a balanced position. Osteoporosis can make a significant impact on height. There are other factors that can contribute to shrinkage, like loss of cartilage height in our hips and knees or falling of our arches in our feet. But as a spine surgeon and specialist, I can say the most significant factor causing age-related shrinkage is your spine. I hope you have a better understanding of this process. This is Dr. John Shim, and I want to thank you for your attention. Thanks.